Hello and welcome to RTC TV4, where we are here at Triton High School, where the Rochester Lady Zebras are playing the Lady Trojans of Triton. We are about to tip off here. Emma Dahlquist and Nicole Segrist are in the center circle to tip off for their team. And Triton gets the tip. And Quinn Downing, the point guard for Triton, gets the offense set up.
Looks like they're staying close on number 12, Hannah Wanamaker.
It's like a box and one defense for the Lady Zebras. And Wanamaker's shot is rebounded by her own team. They actually triangle in two with Wanamaker and Nicole Segrist. And Downing picks up her dribble, looks to give it away. And first shot is good by Courtney Jennings. Morgan Ruff will take the basketball for the Zebras. And Shively kicks to Ruff in the corner, down to the post to Musselman, and her shot is good. Score's tied at two. And Wanamaker gets the ball in the corner, back up to Downing at the top of the key. Triton working to break this triangle and two defense that the Lady Zebras are set in.
Maddie Shively doing a nice job on Wanamaker over there.
Very nice job.
They're setting a lot of screens to try and get Wanamaker open, but she's fighting through them and her teammates are helping her out a lot.
We've been that girl a couple times where playing face guard defense and having a lot of help from your team.
A few elbows here and there, just trying to fight through all the screens.
Yep, very important.
Feels too good.
Very important to communicate as a team there, especially Shively getting beat up in just the first few minutes here, but Rochester is able to force the ball out of bounds, the first turnover by Triton. So actually the first few minutes have taken quite a long time. Score's only 2-2 right now, and Ruff will take the basketball down for the Zebras. And Shively on the wing gets it to Ruff in the corner. Back to Shively. Looks for a pass on the wing. Shively goes down in the corner, and her three-pointer. Was that it? Yep, three-pointer was good. I wasn't sure if her foot was on the line, and that puts the Zebras in the lead, 5-2. Downing has the ball, kicks it over to the corner, gets it back herself. And
Triton taking some long possessions here. It's been 2 minutes and Rochester has only had two possessions in the game. So they're taking their time getting people open and getting around the arc before they find their shot.
I wonder if they knew the triangle and two was coming and they're working through their offense, or if they're kind of making up their offense as they go to try and get a few shots here. They look a little perplexed by the defense. Good call by Coach Stasiak. But a couple rebounds, offensive rebounds that Triton has gotten that Zebras need to box out on. And that's a first foul. Maddie Shively will send Hannah Wanamaker to the line. Wanamaker sets for her first. That is no good. First of two.
It's got to be tying for her as well to be running around back and forth trying to get away from Shively as Shively is as well chasing her.
Knowing she's being face guarded, got to take advantage of these free throws here. And her second one is good. Ruff sets up the defense with a lob pass to Musselman in the paint. Skip pass over to Shively, and Musselman will turn around. Nice shot by Musselman, having a little range there. Zebras are ahead 7-3.
Good talk by the Zebras on the court.
Very
Our
good talk.
Know there's screens coming.
It's the second turnover that the Zebras have cause for the Trojans here. And Ruff drives, kicks back out to Shively, swings it over to Peterson. And Dahlquist shots, no good, but the rebound by Kennedy Musselman is good. So Musselman already having a pretty good quarter here so far, 9-3. Zebras in the lead. And Wanamaker gets it out, kicks it back to Downing. And she'll come out to the corner. Good defense by Dahlquist and a good pickup by Ruff there. Made Downing question her move and ended up into a turnover. And Dahlquist out in the corner, kicks it back up to Ruff, swings it over to Shively. And a scary pass over to Ruff.
Rochester is being patient and looking for their shot as well. Morgan takes a three.
Just bounces out.
Oh, Karina Peterson with the rebound and tipped out of bounds.
I wondered if they call a foul there, end up being off the hands of the Zebras, but everybody seemed to think that Triton had the ball cleared out and Peterson fought for a rebound. So good move by her, and I think that brings Macy Brown into her, in for Karina Peterson.
Macy Brown will now be taking the position of face guarding Wanamaker.
Good move by Coach Stasiak, getting some fresh legs out there, knowing that Shively Peterson did a really good job. Get her a little breather and they can rotate in and out. And good drive, but her shot is no good for Sarah Stevens as Rochester turns and runs. And that'll be a foul on the drive of Morgan Ruff. Fouls on number 12, Hannah Wanamaker.
Get out to the top of the key on the out-of-bounds play. Pass down low, deflected by Wanamaker. We're going to take it back out of bounds now. Ball to Macy Brown on the three. Just missed. Rebound number 24, Seacrest. I'm sorry, Jennings.
And Seacrest kicks it to Jennings on the wing, back up to Stevens. She penetrates around the arc.
Looks like Karina Peterson is about to go in. I'm going to make a guess it's for Maddie Shively to get her a little breather after face guarding for the past 6 minutes. Pretty hefty amount there.
Good rotation set up for the Zebras, having a lot of good defense here. Only one shot. Triton's only been able to have this quarter. Just a three-pointer by Wanamaker. And Jennings gets it out on the wing. Excuse me, Stevens. Up to Morris. Over to Jennings. She'll look to pass. And Seacrest gets it over to Stevens, who takes a shot. That's no good. Good box out. Macy Brown, good box out, following all the way through, allowing Kennedy Musselman to get that rebound.
See if we can run some time off the clock here for the Zebras, I think. Gonna get a little ball movement. Steal by Wanamaker, number 12, Triton, going back to the other end.
And Courtney Jennings' three-pointer is good. That'll be not a shot that Rochester likes to see, as they held them off for most of the first quarter and ends up getting two three-pointers. Sure, they'll like to hold it here for the last 50 seconds and get one more shot off.
Morgan Ruff at the top of the key, dribbling the ball, just waiting for time to expire.
And no pressure by the Trojans, so there's no count. We could just fast forward the clock here and make it easier for everybody.
Triton getting a little direction from the coach as to where he wants them set up, and as well as Coach Stasiak directing his team.
I'm guessing Morgan will go with about 10. We might have a little help here knowing that we've done this once or twice.
Just a few times.
And Macy Brown in the corner, her three-pointer is no good. rebound is a tie up on the ground. And the ball stays with Rochester. So they'll put in a couple quick subs with 2.4 seconds left in the first quarter. Zebras are going to need to catch and shoot here to get a last second shot before the end of the quarter.
Maddie Shively face guarded that entire quarter. Props to her for holding her own on that.
And Musselman's shot was no good. Not enough time to get a rebound. That's the end of the first quarter. Score is 9-6. Zebras in the lead. We'll be right back. And we're back for quarter number two. Score is 9-6. Lady Zebras in the lead. Triton will have the basketball going to our left. And Downing controls the ball. Passes over to Miller. Drives the paint. Kicks it out. And Downing has the ball again to the corner where Sarah Stevens' shot will be no good. And the ball will be off of White, out of bounds. The ball goes to the Zebras. Morgan Ruff and Peterson at the top of the key there. Ball's deflected out of bounds by Triton. Risky pass there for the Zebras. They needed to wait back and work the offense just a little bit more. Peterson has the ball out of bounds for the Zebras. Gets it to Macy Brown in the corner. She dumps down to the post. Musselman turns and the shot's no good. Courtney Jennings has the ball. Over to the corner, back up to Downing at the top of the key. Triton doing a better job, I think, of really having quick rotations, not allowing the Zebras to catch up as quickly as they're on defense here. And Jennings drives. Sarah Stevens down to the post, back up to Jennings, and her three-pointer is no good. Excuse me, that's Whitney Miller. Her three-pointer was no good. Ball out of bounds on Triton. Lady Zebras have the ball.
Maddie Shively in for Kennedy Musselman for the Zebras.
Ruff handles the ball for the Zebras. Skip pass over to Shively. She penetrates, gets it to Dahlquist, back up to Macy Brown. Her three-pointer is good. Little motivation there and some momentum for the Zebras. Score is 12-6 here in the second quarter. Skip pass to the top of the key, over to Downing, over to Miller. She penetrates, kicks it out to Downing.
Looks like the Zebras are in a zone defense now.
A 1-3-1, Macy Brown, the freshman at the top of the key there, looking to penetrate. There is Miller, and her shot is no good. Ball's tipped around, but Shively ends up with it, gives it to Ruff to run the offense. and Ruff penetrates but ends up traveling. Ball goes back to the Trojans. And pass down to the post. Nobody around for the Lady Zebras, and that's Nicole Segrist with her first points of the game.
Morgan Ruff passed down to Macy, who passed it down to the post. Ball gets scrambled up. Kennedy saves it from going out of bounds. Skip pass over to Maddie Shively. Foul on Triton.
And that's Caitlin Bailey with the blocking foul. Out of bounds for Zebras.
Pass the ball in from out of bounds to Macy Brown and just barely got it to her too soon to Morgan Ruff, who was still out of bounds slightly on the pass back.
And Quinn Downing has the ball for Triton over to Whitney Miller, back to Downing, over to Jennings. And Triton doing a mixture of being patient and also having quick reversals when they do decide to run their offense. This is Jennings for a three-pointer, and that is good. Ends up being a two-pointer, foot was on the line. 12 to 11, just like that. Triton's trailing only by one. And pass to Macy Brown on the wing. Her three-pointer is good as she answers with a long shot. Downing runs the offense for Triton. Over to Stevens. Back to Downing at the top of the key. She studies the offense and the defense. And penetrates the paint, gets it over to Jennings with a shot fake. Swings it back over to Miller. She dumps it down to Segrist. Back to Downing at the top, over to Miller. Downing kicks it to Jennings. Jennings returns it. Miller has it on the far side. And Jennings runs through, shot not open. Loss of patience here by the Triton offense. And Jennings keeps running baseline, no shots in the corner. There will be a shot from the paint. And that's no good. And Macy Brown with a three-pointer, that's no good. Almost gets her own rebound, but Triton has it instead. And Downing has it on the wing. Back over to Miller with a shot fake. And good defense by Ruff. Only 2.5 minutes left in the half. Quarter's going pretty quickly, in my opinion. And that's a long shot by Miller. No good. Morgan Ruff runs to the other end. And Macy Brown wide open in the post. Brown gets it on the wing, dumps it down to Musselman, not able to handle it. Triton gets the ball back. And good pass down low. Segrist with the sneak again. The second time it happened, but the second time the ball did not fall in. That's a tough shot to miss there for the Trojans.
It looked as though all the Triton players thought it was in. They ran back to play defense, and thankfully Rochester girls hung around to get the rebound.
And that's a block out of bounds.
Sub for Rochester, number 54, Emma Dahlquist, in for Karina Peterson.
Shot Shively gets the ball in to Ruff. Minute and a half left in the quarter. Trojans trailing by four. And dump down low is too high. Dahlquist not able to reach it. Ball goes to Triton.
Looks like we have Emma Dahlquist up at the top of the zone for Rochester, trying to get some pressure in there with her length, see what she can do. It did create a turnover on that possession.
And Ruff handles the basketball. Wonder if the Zebras will hold for this last minute.
Some pressure by Triton's defense.
And that ends up being a turnover. And flip ahead to Downing. She pulled it out. Instead of getting the layup, she decides to get this last shot here. Jennings is wide open, and her shot's no good. Sechrist gets the rebound, and she's fouled by Musselman. And Sechrist's first free throw is no good.
Karina Peterson, the sub in for Maddie Shively for Rochester.
Sechrist prepares for her second free throw, and that's no good as well. But Triton gets the long rebound. No good for the Lady Zebras. And Miller has it. Kicks it over to Bailey. And Sechrist has it up top. Gets it over to Downing. Less than 40 seconds to go in this quarter here. Zebras in a little bit of a trap defense. And Triton will call a timeout. 33 seconds left to go in the half. We'll be right back. And we are back from the Triton timeout. Score is 15-11. Rochester in the lead. 33.6 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Rochester applying some pressure here so Triton doesn't get the last shot. And Downing has the ball for Triton. Gets it to the middle and Jennings. Over to Miller. Rochester with the trap. Downing has it at the top of the key. Less than 20 seconds to go. And into the middle with Jennings. Bailey has it in the corner. Back to Miller. There's about 5 seconds left here in the first quarter. Jennings at the top of the key gets it to the corner. Miller can't get a shot off, and Ruff has the basketball. And that's no shot. We will be back for the second half. And we're back for the second half here. Rochester Lady Zebras have the basketball going to our left now. Starting the third quarter, the score is 15-11. Rochester up by 4. Thoughts on the first half?
I think that Rochester did a nice job of playing defense on their better players, on Triton's better players, and holding them to minimum possessions. And when they did have possessions, they were long ones because they couldn't find an open shot.
Absolutely. Rochester turns the ball over, and Downing takes it for Triton the other way. And Downing kicks it over to Segrist. She drives the paint. She'll kick it back out to Downing. And the shot by Charlotte Morris is good for 2. Triton now just trailing by 2.
Triton in a 1-3-1 zone.
And Musselman handles it. Great look pass there for Morgan Ruff down to Dahlquist. And that's not an easy pass to handle. Dahlquist did a good job catching and putting it up for 2. Downing goes the other way for Triton. And Segrist around the arc. And Downing puts up a 3-pointer. That is good. And Triton only trailing by 1 now. That's a big momentum boost there for Triton. Rochester holding the lead the entire game. Ruff will handle the ball, and Triton goes into a trap of their own. We saw a little bit of that from the Zebras. And another great pass on the opposite block there by Emma Dahlquist. Good look by Morgan Ruff. That's 2 back-to-back possessions. That shot has been successful.
Emma Dahlquist with a little more pressure on that shot, but still able to handle it.
And Segrist has it around the arc, looks to shoot, decides not to. And then she takes a couple dribbles, and that shot's no good, but Downing will get the rebound. And she kicks it to Jennings, over to Segrist. She penetrates down low and tries for the over-under, and that's no good. Musselman will get the rebound, and Ruff will run the other way. And a little trap going there for Triton. Ruff gets around it. Good lob pass. Down to Musselman. Her shot. She's fouled on the shot.
Those have been 3 great looks by Ruff, getting a teammate open there and making sure that she gets the ball in someone's hands that's open.
Very good passes off the dribble. She doesn't stop and take too much time. She takes 1 dribble and gets rid of it like a hot potato, and that's how those shots will be successful. Musselman's first free throw is good. Something Triton struggled with in the first half was free throws. Rochester didn't shoot many, if any, in that first half. And Musselman's second free throw is good. And Triton doesn't have anyone to get the ball. Downing will have it now, crossing the center line. And Jennings dribbles over, looks to get it to Wanamaker in the corner. There's a triple team by the Zebras. Back to Jennings, and her 3-pointer goes in and out. Musselman has the rebound. Ruff runs the other way. And she dribbles around the defense. And there will be a foul on Jennings, but good baseline penetration by Morgan Ruff to skip that out to Shively on the wing. Ruff has the ball out of bounds. And lobs it over to Peterson. Ruff gets it in the corner. And a nice lead pass. Post's not ready for that. It'll be a turnover. Triton heads the other way. And Segrist has it out on the arc. Looks to get it in the corner. Teammate goes the other way.
That was to Wanamaker, who was being face guarded by Maddie Shively. Wanamaker trying to get away, just trying to go every other direction to shake Shively, but Shively does a good job and hangs with her.
And Ruff takes it across. Triton preparing for a trap defense here. Should be able to break it since they have 1 of their own. And Shively gets it over to Dahlquist, over to Ruff. Ruff has a deep 3-pointer. That one's off the mark, and rebound by Musselman, that's no good. There'll be a jump ball underneath the basket between Shively Peterson and Charlotte Morris. Macy Brown now in for the Zebras. She went in for Karina Peterson. She will be taking over the position of face guarding number 12, Wanamaker. And baseline drive by Segrist, not an option there. Gets it to Morris, gets it back to Segrist, and that will be 3 seconds in the lane for Morris. Ref brings it across the timeline. Brown skip passes over to Shively on the opposite wing. Good feed down to the post. And Musselman's shot is no good, but she's fouled. Two good free throws a few possessions ago. Score is 21-16, Zebras in the lead. First free throw for Musselman is good. And Musselman's second free throw good as well. Big points there at the line for the Zebras. Like we said, Triton not able to use that in the first half. Musselman 4-for-4 on her free throws so far. 23-16, Zebras in the lead. And Segrist has it. Looking to pass, she ends up driving, and she's got a long layup that doesn't fall in, and Ruff will grab the rebound. Macy Brown in the corner, catches and shoots her three-pointers in and out, and Triton has the rebound. Brown doing a nice job of chasing. And that was a block attempt by Kennedy Musselman. Ends up being a foul on number 34, Morris. Tough to block behind as a post player. Usually it's difficult not to get the body on there. First free throw for Morris, no good. Rochester has Karina Peterson in for Kennedy Musselman. Free throw number 2, no good. Rebound number 24 for Triton Jennings. Miller has it at the top of the key, over to Segrist, doesn't know if she's going to shoot, decides that, well, I guess she'll just have a three-pointer here, so that gives a little boost to Triton as it's 23-19, four-point lead by the Zebras. And good ball rotation as Triton's going to trap. Morgan Ruff's three-pointer is blocked. Macy Brown puts one up herself, and that one is good. Lots of long balls today. We've seen a couple layups and a lot of three-pointers, but not any mid-range jumpers. Miller penetrates, kicks it back up to Segrist, and Miller gets it back. Good crossover move down low, and her little bunny jumper goes in. 26-21, Zebras in the lead. And Brown and Morgan Ruff have a turnover at the top of the key there. Very hard to keep the ball going back and forth without jump stops and good passes. Triton knows that they're trying to hold that. So meeting your passes and good passes are important here for the Zebras, especially with the score so close. Morgan Ruff has a leading pass that's not able to go through. Triton steals that one. That's back-to-back turnovers that the Zebras would like to have back. The last couple turnovers have resulted in points for Triton. Rochester slowly losing their lead. So hopefully they can turn it around here. And Morris kicks it to Whitney Miller, over to Downing. And Jennings kicks it back to Downing, over to Miller. Downing has it at the top of the key. looking for a last-second shot. 1 minute left, and they have a tough pass down low. Peterson with the steal gives it to Ruff, who runs. She does not have numbers, ends up pulling it out. I think she's going to try and hold for a last shot. Brown has it. Back to Ruff. Skip pass over to Shively. Good pass meeting by Macy Brown there. And Ruff draws the foul from Miller. That'll be out of bounds for the Zebras. Able to set up an offense with about 50 seconds left here in the third quarter. Pretty quick game so far.
Kennedy Musselman coming in for Macy Brown for the Zebras.
Shively gets it into Ruff. Few substitutions.
Trying to take a little pressure now.
Screen at the top of the key there for Ruff. And she's close to the center line, making me nervous. And good screen, but a foul from Stevens on Morgan Ruff.
Macy Brown coming back into the game. Coming in for Maddie Shively. Get some help on the guard front there for Morgan Ruff, giving her a little more pressure at the top of the key.
A trap in the corner leads to a turnover. Ball goes out of bounds off of Gray, they say. And that will be Triton with the ball. 24 seconds left in the game.
Maddie Shively back in again for Macy Brown. Rotating them in and out on offense and defense. Rochester is in a zone defense, and Triton is going to hold the ball at the top of the key and try and get a last second shot, not rushing anything.
9-8 seconds left here. Triton goes for their offense. Like you said, Rochester in 1-3-1. Seacrest has it in the paint, tries a move. That's blocked. Musselman gets the rebound. Ruff, not enough time. That's the end of the third quarter. We'll be back for number four. We're back for the beginning of the fourth quarter here. Score is 26-23. Triton has been down this whole game, but Rochester not having a huge lead the whole time. Ruff struggling against the trap defense there. She has a long pass that Dahlquist barely hangs on to, and she'll actually get fouled in that process. Didn't think she was going to get that pass.
That was a nice athletic play on her part by reaching up there with her long arms and pulling that down and still keeping a handle on it. Very impressive.
Absolutely. Ruff has the ball out of bounds for the Zebras. And the lob to Musselman. She'll turn and be fouled once again. She's done very well all night with her free throws. Musselman's first free throw is good. I think she's perfect for the night so far.
Let's not jinx it.
Yeah, sorry. And six for six. Good job at the free throw line by Musselman. Triton has the ball. And Stevens will bring it across the line. She gets it to Miller, who penetrates down low. Tries to shoot around Musselman. That's no good. Dahlquist gets the rebound. Ruff will run the other way. It's a tongue twister there.
Ruff run.
And Peterson has it in the corner. Has a trap. It's got to get it out.
Got it
kind
out
of
corner?
Didn't. Yep.
Not as solid of a handle as we would have liked, but
that'll be a turnover. And Wanamaker.
That just proves why she's being face guarded.
Absolutely. I think that's only her second shot of the night. Both of them have been three, so good job by Rochester not to let her touch it, but kudos to her for making it happen when she does. And Shively will have the ball at the wing.
Rochester was getting a little flustered by the pressure.
And what looked like a bump, potentially a foul on Triton, the referees called a travel on Dahlquist. Depends on what angle you were. That's difficult. Stevens will handle the ball again for Triton.
Macy Brown on number 12, Wanamaker face guarding her. Teammates helping her out with the in and out screens.
And Stevens has it at the top. Wanamaker trying to get open. Seacrest goes for a three-pointer once again. That one rolls around, and Musselman has the rebound, gives to Ruff, who runs. And at the top of the key, Ruff looks for a three-pointer, but it's blocked.
Taken as a pass.
Great job. Great
long pass.
Great
Morgan
pass to Dahlquist there, and she puts in two. And Steven has the handle for Triton. Seacrest penetrates, gets it back to Miller. Excuse me, Stevens, now to Miller. Back to Stevens. And over to Bailey in the corner. She tries to get it down to Seacrest, and that'll be a jump ball between Seacrest and Musselman. And Seacrest will be subbed out. Might have had a little bit of a fit there, throwing the ball at the referee. Not usually good to do that.
Not usually. They won't really get them on your side.
Nope. So Stevens has the ball out of bounds for Triton. They'll lob it up to Downing at the top.
With Wanamaker being out, that puts Rochester in their zone.
Very good move there, giving all the defenders a little bit of a break with Wanamaker being on the bench. They can, like you said, be in more of a relaxed 1-3-1 zone. And Jennings has it in the paint. She drives, kicks it back to Miller. She will go for what should be a long two-pointer. That's no good. And Peterson with the rebound gives to Ruff. 5 minutes left here in the entire game. Macy Brown has the ball, and her three-pointer goes off the backside of the rim. Dahlquist gets the rebound. She puts it back up. Great, powerful move. Bounces off the backboard. Thought she had it, but she's fouled for two.
Nice job on her part for not giving up and looking for an outlet pass. She went strong to the basket like she should have.
Very absolutely. Nice. Went for it and drew the foul.
Two big free throws here for Rochester.
And the first one rolls around. No good for Dahlquist.
Three subs in for Triton.
Wanamaker, Seacrest, and Jennings will come back. Three key players of the night. Got a quick breather. And her second free throw is good. Coach Stasiak will call a timeout. Less than five to go in the fourth quarter. 31-26. We'll be back. Thank you. And we're back after the 30-second timeout. Triton has the ball going to our right. Jennings looks down low as Wanamaker runs the baseline, Downing all by herself on the far side of the court here. Triton sets up their offense. And Jennings has it, looks to drive, and she is going to be fouled by Morgan Ruff. Foul on the floor, they'll take the ball out of bounds. Jennings has it out of bounds. She'll get it into Downing. Jennings drives once again, backs back out over to Downing. And lots of quick passes around. Wanamaker has the ball. She'll give it to Morris. Segrist over to Downing, back to Segrist. And Triton being very patient, Rochester having some solid defense there. Segrist has it up on the arc. And she gets it out to Downing. No one's very close to her, but her three-pointer does not fall in. Both teams trying to slow it down here. 31-26 here. Almost 3 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Rochester looking for a good shot, good bounce passes here. And Triton's going to get a little bit of pressure defense. Skip passes open on the far side, but we need a little bit higher of a pass. And Peterson tries to keep it in. And that'll be a ball out on Rochester. Downing has it for Triton. And Morris in the middle. Back to Downing on the wing. And there's going to be a foul on Macy Brown. It'll be a holding foul on Wanamaker. Hard to see that one coming. Usually it happens around the ball. That was a foul, and Triton will take it out. Wanamaker gets it at the top of the key, tries to shoot, not there. Downing has it on the wing. Jennings at the top of the key. And a lot of ruckus going on in the gym. I think Wanamaker had a push off. There's a little battle, maybe getting a little frustrated being face guarded for four quarters. And that will be a foul on Wanamaker, who will get subbed out for, and Zebras will get the ball. Zebras looking to spread this out here. And good pass decision to go away from the running Trojans.
Nice job on Morgan's part for staying in athletic position but not necessarily dribbling the ball right away.
And tough shot there by Musselman. Her layup goes in and out. And Dahlquist goes over the back with a foul, trying to aggressively get that rebound. Looked like a very promising play that didn't end up in the Zebras' favor. And 31-26, 2.5 minutes left to play in the game here. Zebras in the lead. Zebras in a 1-3-1 zone. Segrist has it on the wing, back to the top for Downing. Trailing by a few points, but still looking for a decent shot here as Triton's very patient. Segrist tries to penetrate, but for her shot fake, there was a travel, so Zebras will get the ball back. Kind of a sloppy game here in this last quarter. I think we saw a lot of aggression in that first quarter, but we've had quite a few turnovers here lately for both teams.
Both sides are trying to slow it down a little bit, and the defense is trying to pressure, so it's a little bit crazier. We have Maddie Shively that came in for Emma Dahlquist for the Rochester Zebras.
And Triton will put on a full court press here, and Macy Brown gets it over to Shively. She'll drive, and her layup will be no good, and I think there was an over-the-back call. Kennedy Musselman fouls. It looked kind of like there was a trip or a fumble, but over-the-back call there, and Triton will have the ball.
Some ruckus in the crowd.
A little bit of ruckus over here. And just, the band playing in the background.
There's 2 minutes left. Let's hold off here.
So, very good look by the Triton team as they find Segrist wide open underneath. That puts the score a lot closer than the Zebras would like. Triton's going to call a timeout, and we'll be back after this. And we're back after the Triton timeout. 1 minute and 40 seconds left to play. Now a 3-point game. Rochester in the lead. Triton yet to have a lead this game. They are in a pressured, full court pressure defense. I'm assuming it will turn into a trap here, and Macy Brown will be bumped out of bounds, and that will be Triton basketball. So very crucial time here with only a minute and a half left to go. Zebras up by three. And Rochester in a 1-3-1, Wanamaker not in the game. There's no face guarding going on, and Triton looking for a good shot. Jennings gets it in the corner, back to Miller. Lots of ball reversals here, looking for an opening, and Bailey will have it in the middle, back out to Downing, to Jennings in the corner. This will be a big shot. That
ties it up.
Is a tie game. It looked good when it left her hands, and bad news for the Zebras here as the game is tied less than a minute to go. We've got to have a big shot, just any shot here by the Lady Zebras. And there will be a timeout called by Coach Stasiak.
Emma Dahlquist will be the sub in when we come back.
And we're back after the timeout. 46.2 seconds left to go in the game. First time that Triton has been tied with the Lady Zebras. Zebras have held the lead the entire game. And Corinna Peterson will take the ball out. Morgan Ruff has it. Zebras probably looking to get off one shot here. No chance for the Trojans to get a score on the other end. She will try and drive through the defense, and that will be a ball on the floor and a jump ball. Possession stays with the Zebras. That is a scary play and very good for the Zebras. Ruff will take the ball out of bounds.
Saved herself by jumping on that ball to at least get the jump ball in that situation.
Yep. And ball in to Macy Brown. She loses the handle, gets it back to Ruff. And 25 seconds left to play here. Looking to get one shot off, and if not, there's overtime possibility. And Brown has it in the corner, gets it back out to Ruff. 15 seconds left to play. Ruff will drive down. Dahlquist will have a layup that is missed. And there's a timeout by Triton. 8 seconds left in the game. Triton with the basketball. We'll be right back. And we're back after the timeout. There are 8.2 seconds left in the game. The score is tied 31-31. Triton has the basketball on the far end from their basket. Zebra's going to set up a full court press.
Matching up.
Don't want any fouls here. And Miller will get the basketball. She's going to run down on the other end of the court. The layup is fumbled. The ball is fumbled around. Holy moly, what just
that
happened?
That was craziness.
That should have been a layup by Triton. Ball was fumbled around about 14 times, went out of bounds, score ran out. We will be heading into overtime here shortly. Game is still tied. We'll be back.
Not a good time to have me on the microphone.
You go away.
Fourth quarter into overtime. Now we're going to have another tip. And that was a crazy last 8 seconds of the game. We thought Triton had the layup wide open. There was a fumble.
In that last 8 seconds, it could have been anyone's.
Yeah,
it
anyone
could have had it.
Really intense going on there. So we've got 4 minutes left to play and a tie game. Emma Dahlquist gets the tip to Morgan Ruff for the Lady Zebras, still going to our left. And Dahlquist gets it down low, and that will be a ball out of bounds on the white team. Zebras keep the basketball.
Dahlquist got a little stuck underneath. She tried to pass it out. It got deflected, but still in possession of Rochester. Morgan tries to drive, and she gets fouled on the drive. That is Triton's 10th foul, so she will have 2 shots. Morgan Ruff on the line for 2.
I don't even remember when they had the 1-1. I think during the time of 1-1, they were all shooting fouls, so
yep.
It came to the bonus pretty quickly.
I think so too.
And that first free throw is no good. These are going to be crucial points here in the next 3.5 minutes.
Maddie Shively coming in now for Kennedy Musselman for the Zebras.
second free throw falls in. They're going to get into a full court pressure defense here. And Jennings runs all the way, but kicks it back out to Seekers, to Miller, over to Downing. And Jennings has it for a three-point attempt, and that's no good. Ruff with the rebound. And ball stripped away by Miller. She goes to the other end, and her layup is good. That is the first time Triton will lead this entire game. 33-32, Triton in the lead.
Triton with a little bit more momentum now. Rochester needing to push themselves up there. Triton in a zone. Rochester trying to penetrate the gaps. Ruff with a three, no good. Rebound Maddie Shively, and a putback. Good for two. That puts Rochester up 34-33 with under three left in overtime here in Triton. Triton passing it around the perimeter. Rochester trying to get a trap down there in the corner. Downing holding it up at the top of the key. Drive in and a little kick back there for number 14, Miller. Back up to the top to Downing. Seacrest up for a shot, no good, rebound. We're actually going to have a mix-up and then a foul on Seacrest, number 22, which will have Maddie Shively to the line for two. Karina Peterson to the line for two, my bad. That is Triton's 11th foul, so she will have two automatically at the line. Shot is good. That is big for Rochester, making it 35-33 with 2 minutes left. And we have Kennedy Musselman back in for the Zebras. She came in for Maddie Shively. Karina Peterson here with her second free throw. And that is good. That puts Rochester up by three with 2 minutes left in overtime. Downing coming down the court with the ball. Dribbling around the top of the key, looking for someone to get open, waiting for screens. Passes it over to Seacrest. Back out to Downing. Over to Seacrest for a three, and that is good. That ties us up here in overtime with a minute and 30 seconds left. Ruff coming up the court, dribbling it slow, trying to spend a little time. See what they can do with this last minute and 30 seconds. Yeah, she dribbles it off her foot. There goes another turnover. Triton coach telling them to slow it down, so Downing takes it to a walk and dribbles it around the top of the key. Still a minute left, tied 36-36. Triton has the ball. Try and hold the ball for one shot. Macy Brown face guarding number 24, Jennings. Everyone else is in a box and one defense.
And no pressure by the Zebras here. They're going to let the clock run out. Triton hoping for one last shot.
Rochester starts to pressure. Got a trap over in the corner on Seacrest. She dribbles it out. We have a foul on Karina Peterson. That is only Rochester's sixth, so that will be taken out of bounds. Next foul is a one-and-one opportunity for the Trojans, though.
That's very, very important. If Rochester would have fouled multiple times, that would have put them at the line. And instead of out of bounds, Triton would have had a chance for the go-ahead points. We are in a timeout when we will be right back after this.
I have one bar left, so if it does go into double overtime,
we're going to have to use this.
We're going to have to. We'll just jump to it because I'm not going to even. But I don't know if it goes straight from one bar to like dead.
I know.
Flash.
Does it say how many minutes is left? It should flash. It should flash no bar before it.
God, somebody please. Win.
You want to do it? You want me to? are back here with overtime, 36-36, 41 seconds left here in Triton. Triton with the ball, Downing at the top of the key, trying to hold the ball to see if we can get, they can get one last shot. Rochester with a little bit of pressure, passing around, get an open shot. Nice help defense by Kennedy Musselman. Way to step over. We have another timeout, this timeout called by Triton. They're going to be taking the ball out underneath when we come back.
Yeah, I know.
And we are back again. Triton still has the ball. They are taking it out underneath now. There's 27 seconds left. It is still tied. Triton lobs it in over into Sechrist. She gets it back out to the top to Downing. A little pressure by Rochester, trying to make him get a shot off. Emma Dahlquist coming up now to pressure Sechrist. 10 seconds left. Shot off now. We're going into double overtime. It is a tie game. Triton with the go-ahead shot right there for the win. Wide open layup just over the basket. That puts us into double overtime. We'll be back.
Let's check batteries. I don't know. I don't know. Check this. I don't think we have extra. Get that.
You don't think there's anything in there?
Here, get this just ready just in case.
What is it?
Where is the mic? Yeah, if your camera goes dead.
This will stop. My battery's too low on my phone.
I know, my phone is dead.
We have 2 bars on this, but.
No, if that camera dies, we're gonna have to.
You gotta plug it into that?
Yep. Oh, what are we plugging into that? The audio. Post.
So then there would be no audio. It would just be, there would be no video.
Why don't
audio.
We just run it off that now? Somebody wants to show off it.
Because we've got to do that. Here. We should have done that switch then, but I never saw it. Ready?
We are back and we are in double overtime here for the Rochester Zebras versus Triton Trojans. We had a last second just over the basket layup missed by Triton, and the tip from Emma Dahlquist goes to Morgan Ruff. Three up for Macy, turns into a pass to Kennedy for the 2 points. That puts us at 38-36, 4 minutes in this overtime. Triton passing around the perimeter, looking for an open shot. Rochester playing some nice pressure defense.
I think I jinxed this earlier, Becky, when I said that the game was going pretty quickly and it turned around to be double overtime.
The regular game went quickly. This,
yes.
And then, so they were just
this
preparing
whole overtime
us for
stuff.
The...
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Triton with some pressure. Back and forth, a little trapping in the corners. Nothing too extreme yet. We have a timeout for Rochester, 30-second timeout. We will be back after this.
Don't do that. Hey. It popped up on there.
Who wants to record their cameras? said, who wants to record their camera's menu?
I know, right?
I was seeing if I could turn down the screen brightness, so I was still like,
I know.
Trying to save that.
It'll be okay. We've literally battled through everything. Ready?
Worst case scenario, you don't get the double overturn.
It's still got one bar left.
And we're back from the timeout. Rochester Zebras with the ball going to our left for the double overtime. Morgan Ruff with the ball passed in from Karina Peterson. Morgan brings it to the top, taking things slow, trying to get their shot open. Over to Katrina Peterson. She is trapped over in the corner. She needs some help to get out there. And we have another timeout called by Stasiak to try and get us out of that jam. We will be back after this timeout.
You know, I thought it was going to be home maybe at like 10 o'clock. And then when I started looking at
back again. We had very few timeouts called in the four quarters of the game, but here with the overtime, we have had many timeouts called with the crucial points that this game has come to. Ball passed in to Morgan Ruff. She's at the top of the key. Triton showing some pressure and trapping in the corners. Morgan holding it as long as she can. Nice jump stop and pass over to Macy Brown. Karina Peterson saved it. She almost lost that ball, but she saved it and jumped on it and recovered it. And good job by Macy Brown to hold her ground. Seacrest comes in to try and get that steal and just plows Macy over. If she did not step into her pass, that wouldn't have happened. So nice job on her part to make an athletic step into her pass. She has two shots at the line now.
Big free throws. This, if she makes both of these, this will be easily the biggest lead in overtime so far.
Sub in for Rochester, number 24, Maddie Shively in for Karina Peterson. Rochester struggling a little at the line in these overtime and crucial points, but I have a feeling we're going to step it up here. Macy Brown with her second one on the way. That one is good. Nice job. Some pressure from Rochester on a full court defense.
Rochester leading by three here. Miller takes it around the defenders, and Seacrest will give it over to Downing.
It is 39-36. Rochester leading with 2 minutes left in double overtime. I still think this three-point lead ties the highest. Like, we had a three-point lead to take us into the first overtime.
Yes.
So not huge leads here in overtimes. It's been pretty back and forth or scoreless.
Triton not seeming very
pressured or
proactive to get the shot here. I'm thinking get a quick bucket, but they're kind of taking their time. They are down by three. I hope they're not trying to go in triple overtime here.
We have a moving screen and a foul on number 34, Morris, which is big for the Zebras. That gives the ball back to them with just a minute 30 left, and they're leading by three. Rochester setting up to break the full court press. Triton did not have it on right away, but they just pulled their defense up.
Good job by the Zebras to be ready for that. Lots of ball rotations, get it across the timeline there. Don't get stuck in the corner. They do. Miller gets the ball, passes it ahead to Jennings, and that'll be a foul on Ruff.
That takes Jennings to the line for two. She makes both of these. Still takes them one possession. They'll still be down by one. First one for Jennings coming up. It is good. Jennings' second one is no good, but the rebound is up in the air, and Seacrest gets the rebound and passes it back out to Downing. That gets us a 39-37 Rochester lead. Triton with the ball and a minute to go. Seacrest shot, air ball straight into the arms of Kennedy Musselman, who passes it out to Morgan Ruff.
That's a tough shot for Triton. Kind of a mid-range jumper. Not sure if you're going to make it or not. Ends up being an air ball. They may end up regretting that shot. And
a turnover straight through the legs. That went through the legs of the Triton defender. Back to Kennedy for a bobble up there. And it ends up being a Triton ball. They're just down by two.
Good job by Musselman not
to jump on that ball and at least make an effort for
not
it.
Not very often you see post players diving on the ground.
That
very good play.
Yes, very aggressive, especially in a crucial point like this. You do everything you can't have, give everything you have to try and get the ball back.
Absolutely.
That is $1 million right there at that point.
Yep. And Triton not having very much success handling this ball as far as some of the passes down low have been tipped around and bobbled. So interesting to see how these next 20 seconds play out as Seacrest drives and her up and under layup. It is going to fall in for a tie game. And the clock's running down to 7 seconds here, and there will be a Zebra timeout. And we will be back right after this.
We are back from that timeout. This is the second overtime. And Rochester was leading by 2 points with 10 seconds left. Triton has the ball, and they tied it up. So there are 7 seconds left. Tie ball game. Morgan Ruff dribbling down the court all the way to the basket. Pass, tries to pass to Kennedy. Bounces off her leg. There's another boggle up in tie game. We are going into the third overtime of the evening. We'll be back. And we're back here with the third overtime of the evening. Emma Dalkus with a tip to Morgan Ruff, passes it over to Macy Brown. Skip pass tipped away, and Miller on her way to the basket. The layup is no good. Rebound Zebras. Morgan Ruff bringing the ball back up the court. Passes it down to the corner to Macy, who skips it across court. The ball is tipped off of her shoulder and hit out of bounds. It goes back to Triton. Downing for Triton, bringing the ball up the floor now. Triton holding the ball at the top of the key, trying to waste some time off of the clock. No pressure by Rochester. Down to the corner for Triton. Down to the post, trying to get it out. Right into the hands of the Zebras. Ruff bringing the ball up the court. Ball gets lost on the drive by Shively, and Triton recovers it and going the other direction. Triton taking their time at the top of the key. Looking for a good shot, trying to waste some time off the clock. Downing really for some pressure by the Zebras. Pass back out to Downing.
tight one here. We're in the third overtime. It's been pretty back and forth. No one's been really in control the whole time. No one's first shot.
Are 0.4 seconds left on the clock. Morgan has already shot her first free throw, and she made that, and she is up for her second. Rochester is up on defense. Before on the first shot, they were playing a little bit back. So Morgan goes up for her second free throw. It is good. Triton takes it out of bounds. Time has expired. Victory, Rochester Lady Zebra Basketball. Thank you so much for watching. This has been RTC TV4.